hope you guys and girls, by the way, can hear the game properly. If you can, do let me know. But fuck, we got some assholes to deal with here. And yeah, this is not good. Not good at all. We might have to retry a few times, but it's pretty weird though, considering that I'm seeing a sort of notification that says Demon Foxhound has gone offline, exiting host mode. Was she here before I even clicked the start live stream? I mean, oh well, whatever. But yeah, let's restart this shit from the very beginning. But those fucking mutts, man, they can be quite a hassle, oh yeah. And we should obviously clean house and continue with our, you know, quest for revenge as Ellie. And let's see what we can do about these cocksuckers. Let's see, how many arrows do we got? Yeah, we need to get rid of the dog first before we take care of the douchebags. And this should be a good shot. And fuck you, mutt. Yeah, fuck you. Yeah, we got the stupid dog, but now we can focus on... sorry, I thought there was 4 arrows, but yeah, we got 3. We had 4, but no more. And we need to take out these bitches one by one. But since they don't have a dog with them, we can pick them off. And once again, sorry, my throat there. It's strange that she'd be offline, even though I never went live, but fuck it. We're still live, and we're still going at it, and yeah, leaving your body unprotected. That's a very smart move on that douchebag's part. Very smart move indeed. Fuck you, bitch. But those who are watching, do let me know, please, if the audio's good. And if I should increase it or not for the game, that is, the game volume. But let's head towards that cocksucker and... yeah, he's gonna get quite a surprise. A very pleasant one. Or in his case, a not-so-pleasant one. But yeah, quote-unquote. Around him. And oh, sniper. I did not notice the goddamn sniper until now. So it's best to pick off that one there. And judging by our sense here, there is only 2. And yeah, we need to definitely head towards this guy before he would, you know, alert any one of his buddies. And sorry, that's my throat. And fuck you, douchebag. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you and die. Quiet, exactly. What I said, what she said. Oh my god, it's like that running gag, if you want to call it that, where basically, you know, he was like, that's what she said. But yeah, let's go inside the cabin here and not be seen by the stupid sniper. And of course, let's use our senses, because the last thing we want to do is alert the... whatever they are, elf hunters or hunt or, you know, whatever, soldiers. But yeah, they're definitely WLF soldiers. And sorry, I thought that I could hear the alert, but no, it wasn't the alert, just some random, I guess, noise, if I even heard anything. But maybe I'm just, you know, a bit paranoid. And that shit can happen sometimes when you're playing a game that's all about stealth and picking off your enemies. If you want to go, unless you want to go all Rambo on them. But yeah, this game. And yo, what's up, sis? I mentioned to the stream that it's quite weird how I read this notification right when I clicked the live stream button that Demon Foxhound has gone offline, exiting host mode. And I was like, how the fuck could she be offline if I haven't even clicked the live stream? But cool, Twitch. And yeah, And it's good you're here though. And we picked off two douchebags after starting with their dog first using this beauty right here. And now we are avoiding the archer right here. No, actually, no, not archer. I wish it was an archer, but a sniper. And yeah, I also mentioned how like this game can make someone like myself very paranoid. And if you can hear the volume, do let me know. If you can't, and I can increase it, also let me know. But yeah, there isn't much items to pick off here, so let's hop all over the window, the now ruined window. And we can proceed this way, which reminds me, if you notice the post I made, one of two posts. Oh, I can hear the audio fine, thank goodness. But if you notice one of two posts I basically left, it's basically me saying like, fuck, Jesus, I want to restart this shit. But yeah, it's basically no, not encounter, but it's basically me explaining the current situation of Dina being left behind since she's pregnant and shit, and of course Ellie going on her own. But yeah, that was the first post before recommending people my Twitter page. And fuck me, yeah, might want to restart again, but I did not see that guy coming from that direction, right? But yeah, it was odd that my what I wrote was erased, you could say, even though I did not do that. Otherwise, I wouldn't post three pictures without a description of said pictures and where are they coming from? And hello there! Fuck me! And yeah, these douchebags won't let us strike them unless we go all, unless we, beat the shit out of them. Yeah. It's frustrating, especially when I get off your stream, post a video I mentioned, do all the preparations and shit, all in a short amount of time. It can be quite hectic. But thankfully, I had my stupid nap because fuck me once again, and I can just focus on this now. But yeah, you want to dance, boy? You want to dance? Fine, let's dance. And I need to also focus on just taking out this guy, and fuck me, you son of a bitch. Okay, come on. Fuck! Jesus, I can't even look at the goddamn camera. Yeah. It can be really crazy indeed, but I couldn't even focus on the stupid guy because of the angle. Let's see. I want to see if I can get a good angle. Let's see. Yeah, come here, bitch. Gotcha. Oh, God, fucking damn it. We need to take his weapon and fuck. Come on. Fuck. Timing and yeah. I think we should probably heal before we deal with these cocksuckers and dodge that. Enter here and fuck you, surprise bitch. Yeah, that would be quite a early highlight, peekaboo and shit. But yeah, fuck it. She down, and let's pick up the axe somewhere here. Where's the axe? I know that one of these cocksuckers dropped an axe. Bingo. Yeah. But funny how we went through the crack here and took them out. But let's see. There's one remaining WLF soldier. Cool. If we can take him out and make mints out of him, and it will be quite delicious. So yeah. But let's see. Let some items here. Wait. I used to have a kind of, weight like this, or just the setup for bench press and all that kind of good stuff. And thanks, sis. Really, thank you. But yeah, that was really sweet and just, instinctive. I just thought of it on the fly, as they would say. But it's pretty tactful, especially since she can't do that crap, which I hate so much, where basically, even if you're running at the whoever, they keep shooting at you and the characters can't seem to basically power through it. What did Batman tell Terry McGinnis when he fought against the Joker in Return of the Joker? It's like power through the Joker's basically attacks and just take it like that. Or like All Might from Boku no Hero Academia when he fought against Doomsday, an equivalent of Doomsday called Nomu. But yeah, he took on his blows and kicked his ass with, you know, plus ultra punch like that. Plus ultra is a cheesy as hell but really awesome hero quote which All Might made popular. And he does have a real name, All Might, but All Might is essentially the anime equivalent of Superman, the almighty godlike being, the closest thing to a god that you will find in a superhero besides Dr. Manhattan from Watchmen. But he is humanized like Superman, especially with Man of Steel and I don't want to say Justice League, but Man of Steel and Batman v Superman. Even though those movies get a lot of unnecessary hate, I mean, are they perfect? No. But Man of Steel in particular, I love because of how it really shows the human side to Superman, Clark Kent, and how the one line I love so much by his mother, Martha Kent, was Clark said, the world is too big, Mom, but then she said, then make it small. That line really stuck with me because, I mean, I really would like to think that there was a point when my mother was kind of like that, but knowing her and the tons of bad memories I have with that bitch, I doubt it, but it's something I taught myself to make the world mine and small. But Jesse, this scene right here is when...
What the hell are you doing here?
Where Joel was shown in the trailer instead of Jesse. But man, did they pull a rug on us, the fans, the idiots at Naughty Dog. But yeah, Superman and Man of Steel get a lot of unnecessary hate, which is annoying as fuck. Even Brett Tier, Tier of Grace, who I used to love on YouTube, man, did he disappoint me when he opened his big mouth and basically agreed with this other douchebag about how bad Man of Steel is. I'm like, both of you bold fucks suck my dick and go to fucking hell, you know? Good old she's sick line. Yeah. Of course. I wish that kept Joel in, but whatever. And Jesse, here's the thing. You didn't care about Jesse's death. I didn't care about his death when I saw it in your stream. So what was the point of switching the roles between them? Why couldn't they have Joel in his place and allow him to die somewhere in the middle? That makes fucking sense. I mean, you could have written it better. I could have done it, considering that we're both writers of fanfics and shit, but only we could do it on... you know, an actual screenplay for a video game like this that's trying to be grounded in realism. But yeah, that's the trend nowadays, but fuck me, I should have gone for that douchebag, but I was too concerned with picking items and shit. But yeah, let's do this and take out this bitch over there. I mean, that's me, honestly. That's not a fucking cartoon character or fictional character, that's me. Oh yeah. Just put blood in my mouth and have me bruised up and shit, and I would pretty much, that's pretty much me, but yeah. And let's take out the other douchebags there. But that's why I love how, you know, once again, between choosing Tommy choosing the community and of course revenge, he chose revenge because... yeah, Maria his wife and shit, but Joel was his brother first and foremost. Without him, he wouldn't even have a chance to find happiness with Maria and fuck you. Yeah, fuck you and dodge up the bitch there. But let's Jesse take this bitch out. Yeah, don't want to waste any ammos. And hello? Yeah, we got him. And I'm glad that... Alright, the stupid car. We got what we need, and I don't want to waste the, I should have switched to a different gun, but silencer. Too bad though, we have no choice in that. But oh, thank goodness we don't have the goddamn fucking silencer equipped. And, fuck you, Lord, and fuck you, douchebags. Let's see, God, fuck. Reloading, seriously? And the crashing shit? Fuck you, bitch. Yeah.
Jesus.
I know this bit. Watch I've seen out. You done it and shaking and yeah, whatever. Reload. Fuck. I want to shoot that son of a bitch. But move in, Jesse. Aim, properly aim, and fight. Shit! The movement. And trying to get a good aim and not waste bullets like they're fucking candy, as John Hartigan said from Sin City. But Lord fucking reload and fuck. Sorry. And, Jesus fucking hell. The goddamn shaking and the reloading and crap. But aim, fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. Fuck you, bitches. We got him though. We did. Fuck you, cocksuckers. WLF bitches. Yeah. Okay, aim. Actually, no. I could do this, but instead go for the goddamn clicker. Yeah, the clickers first. I got some clickers and load. Aim. Fuck. Jesus. Okay. Put one clicker down, and the rest of these douchebags will follow. Yeah, good shot. Oh, you want to play clicker? Sure. How about this bitch? Okay, he's along with the ride, or along for the ride, as that stupid series that's produced by WWE is called, Ride Along, which Mr. McIntyre, who likes to play the corporate puppet and admit that he deserved to be fired, had said in reference to Mr. Orton. But yeah, he deserved to be fired. Basically, he was fired because his stupid ex abused him, domestic abuse, and Vince did not like the fact that he let his wife beat him, even though what could he do? He can't hit a woman, otherwise he'd be looked at as a fucking woman beater, even though she beat him, and yet he is okay with being fired for basically being seen in their eyes as a pussy. Nice logic there. As one guy said in a Reddit page, a very toxic and very disgusting mentality that old man has. That's his quote, by the way, not mine. But yeah, that guy couldn't be more right. And you know, sis, if McIntyre was me, if I was him actually, I would tear that fucking bitch before she even put another pinky on me. But yeah, fuck him. As a hairy Scotsman who calls himself the Scottish psychopath, and yet he let a woman put her hands on him. Kiss my ass, bitch. But yeah, back with her beloved. That shit really pisses me off though. Especially when he basically is admitting that he, you know, quote-unquote admitting that he got fired. It's not being a woman beater, it's self-defense. Exactly. Exactly. I wish the fucking is. It's not even an issue with the fucking douchebags in WWE. The same douchebags who basically allowed Vince to say bark like a dog, basically, to Trish Stratus. It's disgusting, that kind of mentality, and how they say that women competing in MMA is barbaric. Oh, really? And degrading them that way is okay. But yeah. I wish that the company and just American society and the world would stop the sick mentality that it's okay for a woman to put their hands on a man, but it's not okay for a man to defend themselves. Yeah. It's like even this one woman, by the way, who I love so much. I love her to death. Her name is Chloe Sunderland or Roma. Roma Army is her channel's name. She basically said the same thing, how if she punches a guy and she'll give him one chance, basically the same like in Homefront, like she'll give him a chance. If he fights back, she'll fight back even more. I personally like Drew, but in the public eye, you know how people would overreact. Exactly. That kind of shit. It's really disgusting. And to be honest, here's the thing. I don't give a fuck how anyone thinks about me right now, so I wouldn't even give any more shits if anyone were to see me as
Man,
a wife,
I get my own work,
a
bitch. You
beater,
get
a
my
woman
own
abuser.
work.
Hell, even
You should
if
just
someone even
apologize to
were
me.
to call me a pedo or
I just
murderer,
said.
you think I give a shit? I know who I am. I don't need
Okay.
others to tell
Let's
me
go.
otherwise. I do what
Okay.
Mads Mikkelsen did in this movie
I
called
can tell when
The
you're.
Hunt. And yeah, it's good to see Tommy, but he
Stop it, stop
basically
it.
grabbed his girlfriend and
You are
threw
not
her
who I
out of
thought.
his home when she was asking
Okay.
him if he actually raped this young girl, which he never did.
That's
This
right.
young girl just lied about
To
him,
me.
basically
What
putting
the
his
heck?
hands on him, which he never did no such thing. He was innocent throughout, and yet he paid for something that he never even did, which couldn't have been more true to reality, since there are many cases when men have been wrongly accused of raping someone, yet they never did
You want to give
such
it a
thing.
whirl?
They were actually the ones who were raped. But hey, who's gonna believe a
You
man
sure?
being raped
I feel
by a
like
woman half his
it.
size? That sick mentality, you know? But yeah, this is why I fucking hate people, and why I'm glad to be both asexual and, of course,
Sure, Simon.
just single. But let's
Right.
see.
Go
And
with a
let's
pro man
find
earlier,
out.
huh?
Yeah, we need to hit the stupid board since I basically saw you done it
Aim higher.
yourself. Aim
You
higher
broke
to
me,
the
bro.
sign community
Awesome.
and fuck you. Bingo.
Make sure to compensate for the bullet drop.
We need to aim a bit higher. Like that. Huh.
Gonna need to
People
aim.
overall have been completely wrongly convicted. They have, exactly. That's why the justice system
No
in
rush.
the US is so fucking corrupt as hell. I don't know about the rest of the world, but it's so fucking corrupt. And others are like, oh, look at this
Why? What the
disaster going
heck?
on in this state. I mean, it's like, Larry King said to, what's his name? Fucking Nikolaj Coster-Waldau, who was Jaime Lannister in Game of Thrones. But he basically summed up how the greatest crime in American history has been the prison system. But yeah, it's so corrupt and just it needs a lot of fixing that it's gonna take a lot more than just simple talking. But what are we supposed to hit exactly? The sign? Or the cardboard there? No idea. And a bit higher. Higher.
You go.
Oh, right. Attracting these fuckers'
Stop
attentions is
attracting
what we
them.
should have done.
Let's
Not
go.
just us, but worldwide. It's a global issue that nobody seems to give a shit about unless it affects them. Exactly. That's why,
We're out of
really, I don't
control.
give a damn about
Let's
the
clear out.
tragedies that goes on in the world unless it has to do with my friends or my
Take your
family.
time.
That being you and a few others who I do love and care about. Like
No
example,
rush.
this stupid
You're
incident,
fine.
and I'm not gonna mention the city's name, but hundreds of people die and shit. As sad as that is, they don't affect me personally, so
There you
well,
go.
why should I really
Stupid
care?
moron.
But yeah, I'm not even afraid to say it. That's the thing. People can say what they want about me, and I'm not afraid to say or speak my
Gotcha.
mind, unlike these fucking
Let's
pussies
go.
in the company, the WWE.
Try again.
But fuck you, damn it.
I
And
like how
small
false you are.
fries, yeah. Fat smells or false smells, and last douchebag, sorry for my dumbass voice there.
You're natural.
And yeah, natural. Thanks,
That's all of
Tommy.
them.
You're the man.
Here's some more over this way if you want to keep
Yeah,
sipping.
let's go, cowboy.
Okay.
Let's
All
go
right,
and
coming now. Hordes like
chit-chat,
Olympians
or
early in the
we
winter.
can
They always end up
do
leaving
some more
behind just about
shooting.
anyone. They do the same
But yeah,
routes every year.
it really is a
Like a
global issue.
migration, something.
That's never going to be fixed because,
All about
people
it.
are too concerned with
Well,
themselves or
you better let the
tragedies
depression lead
that
to a
only
certain
get so big, and
temperature.
that's when they
Shh,
care.
I don't fucking
Me,
know.
even when it did got big and I got word of it sooner, I never give a damn
Check
as
out my
much as
shit.
others claim that they
Looks like
do.
you're moving
Because
downhill.
here's the thing, why the fuck
Why?
should I? Do they affect me once again? No. Would they give shit about me? I don't even
Man,
expect them to.
look up at the
That's
top.
it's common sense, and that's why
Emotion on
you
that
shouldn't
view.
really
Off there, bro.
Unless you're by yourself and you have no one you really wish to devote your time to, then
In a
it's
while,
best to
get
care about
behind me.
yourself solely. But take out that son of a bitch there and higher, higher.
Physics is wild, isn't
Yeah, I love his accent though. Southern drawl, and let's see if he can get a good shot. But what the
Oh,
fuck? Oh, I thought we had to. shoot whoever, but we need to shoot this guy higher, like that. Bingo.
What's your thing?
And
you.
Over here, fuck you. Good shot.
You're really
and,
good.
And yes. Fuck.
I'm counting.
God damn it. You know, the sniper here is a bit confusing compared to the one in Metal Gear Solid or any shooter games like, say, COD, any one of the COD games, and hell, even Gears of War, but let's take out this douchebag. But that reminds me, I love Foz's line, and actually Marcus Fenix line, like, you know, shut the fuck up, Foz, when he, you know, he was asking Foz his name. But yeah, Foz really is a fucking loudmouth, and he just didn't know when to shut the fuck up. Oh, he was trying to hide behind a tree, or rather, he just so happened to be in front
it's
of the
clear.
Tree, but yeah.
This way.
Mm-hmm. Let's go, cowboy, again. I, you know, I would like Southern Belle more, you know, with her cowboy fetish and shit, if she wasn't, you know, crying every minute about her family on Twitter. But yeah, that's her, whatever, and let's find some more things to shoot. But yeah, I do like the fact that she's into cowboys as much as I am, or even what, you know, just cow folks, but I would never call myself a cowgirl online, but yeah. And what are you looking at, Tommy? Is there someone that I haven't spotted yet, or that I should be aware of? Tommy, what are you looking at, boyo? No idea, but I guess he wants us to attract some attention. But let's see, alright, there, we need to shoot over there. Well, I don't blame her. Yeah, you know, with family and shit. But I don't really, because my family are pretty much shit, but I don't complain about them online when, excluding you, not many people would give a damn about my situation or anything. But whatever. She can cry if she wants to, and let's take out these douchebags and make them cry, because that's what we do, and that's what Ellie does best. But the aiming, oh my god, it's like, you know, if the wind counts, and, you know, using the wind to your advantage, I'd actually appreciate that, and it would make perfect sense, especially that's why, you know, that's different though, yeah, I bet. But that's why, you know, usually snipers in the field have spotters, because to tell them the degrees of angles and where they should shoot. But I wish we could zoom in a bit further, but let's see, we need to kill all of them, I guess so. But wow, so close, and how exactly does this sniper work? Ruby's awesome, I love Ruby, and Liv, she has to work to earn my love, as if she gives a damn though. But yeah, we took them all out. I was gonna say most of them, but all out,
all right.
Yeah.
Let's
and we need
see
to go
cool.
This way.
Sure.
It also reminds me, like, I was watching, speaking of, like, whatever I was talking about, I was thinking of, like, from Star Wars, not Phantom Menace, but the sequel, Attack of the Clones, where basically Count Dooku, who's played by fucking Christopher Lee, who played a character, a certain vampire, Prince of Darkness character called Dracula. So yeah, Count Dracula, Count Dooku, as if that was not a fucking, you know, play on, you know, his career, or just the fact that he's mostly renowned for playing a, I did not notice him here, but he's mostly renowned for playing fucking Count Dracula. But yeah, I love that shit, that meta shit. But I also love when he's talking to Obi-Wan, he's like, you know, trying to be all reasonable and trying to tell Obi-Wan that it's a mistake that, you know, thinking that he's on the wrong side, when actually he's on the side of justice, even though his form of justice is very extreme. And he delivered the famous line, "Join me, Obi-Wan, and together we will destroy the Sith." And Obi-Wan was so casually like, "I will never join you, Dooku." Wow. Dooku is so dramatic, and Obi-Wan's just like, whatever. Imagine saying no to your potential master of the dark side, and you're like, no, like that. But Joel, man, I love him, and I love the younger Tommy too. Both of them, actually. But yeah, Kyle Folks. And the guitar. Oh yeah, I played one mean guitar and then score at the bar. That's basically from the song "Kiss Me, I'm Shit Faced" by Dropkick Murphy. But yeah, you know, when I listened to that song, I was like, no more. When did you start? In regards to him having one night stand with a line of chicks, as he described. I was like, when did you start? But yeah.
You sure you don't want to come?
Get on now.
Yeah. The boy playing the guitar. I love Tommy, and that's why I'm very sad that he would go through a kind of, if you want to call it that, a downward spiral with how obsessed he becomes with revenge.
Okay.
But that's what happens, you know? And Joel?
Oh, thank you.
And I sure do miss Callus. You know, I'm like Joel in that I hate that name, but I do miss Callus. Of all the names, though, of all the fucking names, Callus, that's the name she has chosen. Okay, sure, Ellie, sure. But yeah, Scoot. You know, every time they say Scoot or Scooch, she basically wants her to get on the, when Joel wants to have a ride and shit. But yeah, I was talking about something about Homefront, where I basically described how, like, with Chloe Sunderland, how if she warns a guy once or even twice, if not three times, which is what I would do, you know, to not push any further or push her button or my button any further, and he wants to fight, it's all game, because he had his chance to basically back off and not, you know, continue with this shit, because I don't enjoy it, she doesn't enjoy it, but if you're going to really push it, then it's pretty much all game like that, you know, and what the fuck? Oh yeah, the stupid stone there and shit.
Yeah. He definitely deserved it.
Pretty much. But let's go this way and you know, do what we have to do. By the way, I like that list you put out, you know, with the top friends on Twitter. Pretty cool and cute. Thanks for that. And I love the fact that I got the silver. Won't brag or, you know, lie, but that's pretty sweet. Oh yeah, and we're so close to beating Mandy though. So fucking close. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, the rankings in fucking DMC. Devil May Cry. I love that shit. Yeah, back from refilling Angel's catnip toy with catnip. Once again, you could have told me that, like I told you when I was going to post that video for you on Twitter, but yeah, I was talking a lot, which apparently I was talking to nothingness, and yeah, like I was saying, thanks for the tweet you put out about basically your top list of friends, in which I came so fucking close to beating Mandy. But the silver, won't lie or brag about it, it's pretty sweet. Yeah, you know, like the rankings from DMC, Devil May Cry, boosh, like that. I did hear that. Oh, good, or all right, goody. And it's fine. You can just let me know next time. But it's all right, regardless. And we got some douchebags here because, you know, because I don't want to be wasting my breath talking to really nothing. If I want to talk to nothing, there's the wall over here or the wall around me. But let's open the door here and take care of the douchebags that awaits us. And yeah, this is the moment I believe will do. I get distracted easily. It's fine. It's perfectly fine. When you got a kid to worry about, you can't help it sometimes, or it's beyond your control. And right, we have to go down here. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty awesome though. In that tweet I put out myself of fucking Billy Joe Bob, from Overwatch. I love that shit because he's pretty much me, how I'd react. And when you watch the video itself, my god, the guy that there's a guy called Tommy or whoever he was. I mean, I don't want to assume like his orientation or whatever, especially when he says, "Oh, don't assume my name," but he's making it quite clear that he was flirting with the dude who was posing as a fucking postal dude, you know, Billy Joe Bob, but he came off as flirtatious and very perverted almost. He, like, you know, like, tell me Tommy is stick, or like, I'll suck your dick and that kind of shit. I'm like, and even like, postal dude was like, so wrong. I mean, can't get that out of my mind or some shit he said. But yeah, that's pretty much me, basically. I'm like, dude, we're playing a game now. If you want to date me or fuck with me or whatever, let's do that off camera or when we're not playing online. But right now, we got fucking Zenyatta and other, you know, these very cool designed characters to wipe out, you know. But yeah, that guy though, Tommy, as he wants to be called, Thick Tommy, he's quite a weird pervert, and you know me, I hate them perverts. But yeah, let's open the door here, and voila.
Hello.
Hello. I love these two.
Nope.
I miss them so much.
Eat more?
Come on. If she's not, you know, if she really is full or had her fill of food, then why does she need to eat? I've been told that a lot. You're too skinny. You need to eat more and shit. But I'm like, mind your own business. I'm not telling you you should eat less because of how big they are. So why the fuck should I, you know, be concerned about how small or skinny I am? But let's push this aside. Yeah. For, you know, lying to others or basically telling others that, I'm not immune to any of the spores or just immune to being infected and shit. I mean, it's good disguise, but still, I would never really put that kind of pressure on my kid or just someone who I treat as my kid unless it was absolutely necessary. But I guess in this case it is, and we got some douchebags to kill. But man, when Billy Joe Bob basically said, like, sign my petition, please sign my petition, and then he changed mood instantly, like, sign my petition, damn it, like that, I was like, you know, dude, calm the fuck down. I mean, if you only be more precaution is everything, yeah, if only you are more gentle, or, you know, play it gentle, they would probably sign your goddamn petition. But yeah, and let's reload our gun, on no need to. But it was a pretty hilarious video. It's a prank call, basically, and it took those idiots, Tommy Boy included, around 9 or so minutes, 11 minutes, I believe, and you can quote me on that, to basically figure out it was a soundboard or a recording. Dumbasses. They can't tell from the audio. Wow. I guess when they're distracted killing shit or whoever in Overwatch, they don't really pay attention that much, but whatever. Not all of us can be mindful of our surroundings. That happens to me sometimes when it comes to this game and, you know, the paranoia and shit. And yeah. Mm-hmm. Man. If there wasn't moments like this in The Last of Us 2, I wouldn't enjoy the game as much, but I really enjoy it, and especially the first moment after day one, with them in the spacecraft, or you know, pod or whatever, especially seeing Ellie smile. There was actually a video dedicated to the times they spent together, which does not once show Joel's death. It focuses more on how Joel lived his life. It's like the line from The Last Samurai when Tom Cruise's character, Nathan Ahlgren, was asked by the Emperor to tell him how his master or sensei, Tatsumoto, died, to which he responded very calmly and very beautifully, "I'll tell you how he lived, plain and simple." It's that kind of tale which I love so much. And by the end, the Emperor, who initially had no balls to basically stand up for himself and to be the emperor that his sensei knew he was. He stood up and basically said that we are not going to compromise our culture or our beliefs for anything that, you know, the Western demands of us, is what he said to basically one of the people who was trying to revolutionize or change Japan and make it more civilized or whatever bullshit like that. But yeah. And it was so beautiful how I forgot about that douchebag, but fuck me, and let's back the fuck off. Wait, we need to pick this up. Fuck, and we need to run. We need to run and strike this bitch. And fucking run. Now we need to avoid that cocksucker. The stupid. It's nice comparison. It is. It really is. I mean. I can't think of a better comparison than just that. You could even use Duncan, for example. Like, fuck, the Grey Warden himself or herself, like, said, I'll tell you how, or rather, it's good to hold on to how Duncan lived, basically, and not so much to how Duncan died. But yeah, one after the other, and fuck you, fucking bitch. And yeah, fuck you, fucking bitch. Fucking die. Three down, thanks to the knife, without Joel's help, even though it would have been nice. But yeah, Duncan, the Tatsumoto, basically the emperor's mentor, who tried to teach him the way of the sword and the way of the samurai. And that movie, it's flawed to its core, but it has a lot of beautiful moments, especially when it comes to, like, you know, never forgetting your ways, or in regards to the way of the samurai, because, like, you know, just like how swords were treasured, like they were your own kid in back then, the sword that is for the samurais or even the shinobis, it's about, like, never forgetting how your country was built through this one instrument called the sword. But yeah, we need to back the fuck off and not let these douchebags touch us, and fuck this bitch right here. Yeah, good shot directly to the heart, and thank you. And there is plenty more, I bet. Mm-hmm. Joel cleaned out the rest, and yeah, and fuck you, bitch, fuck you. Good shot, but reload. And let's see, runners, take one out and the other like this, and dodge. Fuck, they're right behind us, and we need to run. Fuck, Jesus, good aim, boy. And we need to get a proper look of the surrounding. And yeah, I got a good look. Aim for the goddamn fucking clicker, and fuck you, bitch. Fuck you. Yeah, surprisingly, I don't think we died, really. I restarted once, but I don't think we died here, which is good in contrast to the beginning. But yeah, good, you know, good change of pace. And plus, it's about, like I said, not wasting your bullets like they're candy, in the words of John Hartigan. But who else is left, and what is he aiming at? Some random loser who I'm not aware of, or whatever. But let's heal, just in case. Unless we, you know, are about to reach the end, which is, I think, doubtful. But what else, Joel? Wait, don't tell me it's glitched like one of the enemies. Oh, wait. It was actually glitched. Then, you know, one of the enemies are caught in some kind of glitch.
I think we did it.
Or I suppose I didn't spot them, but whatever, they're dead. That's what matters. And reload. But yeah, I just love that kind of storytelling. If only it was done better, you know, because it did not deserve to be in that kind of film, which was pretty mediocre. But that Quebecian cunt who I regret to this day ever knowing how it ended between us, but and how much of a prick he turned out to be, like that fucking lesbian bitch I told you about yesterday, who I refused to name because she's somehow a bigger asshole than he was. But yeah, that guy, I can at least, you know, to an extent appreciate him having the guts. And yeah, right, I can at least appreciate him to him having the guts to be honest and that he doesn't really care much to reply to what I wrote before, even though it pisses me off to no end. I would reply back to whatever bullshit he talked about. However, he mentioned, you know, so many times how he had his heart broken by his exes, even though he had 5 exes. One of who, by the way, number 4, I believe, died because of an accident, and she was 22 years old, for fuck's sake. And he moved past her like, oh, it was nothing. A few weeks later, and found another, like, you know, love interest. And this is the same. And she also was someone who believed in God, and yet he never did. And he only believed just because she hoped that she would go to heaven or some shit. I'm like, fuck you, you douchebag. I mean, if you're gonna believe, believe. If you don't believe, don't fucking act like you do just because your girlfriend did. For fuck's sake, there was a wife of this pastor who basically said, I don't want you to believe in the same faith if you don't share it and believe in it wholeheartedly. And he said, no, I do believe, but yeah, fuck him, douchebag. It's a total disrespect to her memory, basically how he moved on past her without even, you know, without even thinking about how wrong it is what he did. But yeah, fuck him. I'm not even surprised that same douchebag would ignore my messages or not even think to reply back or even have the decency to reply back. And fuck you. Yeah. But fucking hell! Yeah, we have a truck here. He was like a fucking a moving truck or train. But I want to pick up that first aid here. But fuck him, honestly. At least he was fucking honest, even though it sickens me how he basically disrespected her memory like that. And we need to move this way. But yeah, fucking faker he was. And I'm tempted to say that I hate liars almost more than fakers, but no, I hate both of them equally. And where's the douchebag? Oh, right. Huh. Got you there, bitch. Got you there. And what the fucking hell? Yeah, your buddy came to save you. Lucky you. But let's see. And be mindful of our surroundings. Come here, bitch. Come here. And we need to get rid of the douchebag right here. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. Now we can actually pay attention to this guy. Let's just find our distance and aim for the fucking head. I'll just shoot him like that and switch to our handgun because we're pretty much loaded, and I'll read your message to one once we're done with this bitch. Fucking hell! Where did you come from? Jesus! Where did he come from? Honest douchebag. Exactly. That's what he was, and thank you, Joel. Thank you. Goddamn. That was supposed to happen. Uh-huh. People praising that muscle-bound bitch for taking down that big monster, yet look what Joel did. So, anyone can do it. Anyone's a badass, and it's just about believing in yourself. The bitch is a cunt. He really is an inhuman cunt. I refuse to call anyone like that a disgusting human being. No, it's just a disgusting, inhuman fuck. How could any real human being have no heart and no soul? It's like, you know, Dante said in DMC1 that, you know, what Trish was back then was a demon, a devil in human flesh and bones, basically disguised as his mother, and she may have her face, but she'll never have her fire and shit like that. But yeah, demons do what that kind of cocksucker did. And the kind of demon he was is the kind I really wish a Dante or fucking Nero, in fact, would wipe out from existence. But man, 22 years old, and that's how you basically treat the time you spent with her? I would never. I say this many times, I'll say it again. If I fall in love once and it's someone who is very dear to me, which is going to be a rarity, especially since things like this really makes me, look down on love and just the idea of what love is, even though I enjoy reading books like on Elias and Mavis and the good stuff like that. But yeah, I will only love only one person, only one. And I refuse to be a fucking bitch cunt like that Quebecian asshole. I wouldn't even look myself in the mirror if I actually reduce myself to his level, you know?
so keen with
same
this
thing, like if I ever made my daughter cry, my adopted daughter, I may as well, like, you know, give her up to some other parents, because I don't want to look at her knowing that I hurt her. Even though she forgives me, I can't forgive myself. I refuse to, because you just don't do that. They say, oh, you don't hurt a dog unless the dog hurts you. But if you're making a baby girl cry, you're a fucking monster, as far as I'm concerned. Especially if it's uncalled for. But let's go this way. But yeah, that's why I love games like Lisa the Painful and The Last of Us, and how, unlike, you know, the thing is, unlike with Joel, I actually see just all the things that Bradley did that was wrong, and how, like, despite how really wrong they were, he did love Buddy, even though it was a toxic kind of love, but he did love her and wanted to protect her. But the last thing that she really wanted was to be trapped in a prison or others' protection, when really all she wanted was for Bradley to train her to protect herself. That's exactly what I would do for my kid, like Jason Statham did for his in Homefront. Sorry, I hate doing that shit. I would normally cut this out, which I will for YouTube, but yeah, I just really hate that crap, hence why I do, you know, pour my mouth and shit. You know, manners, but yeah, Homefront's such a good movie, a damn good movie, one of my favorites actually, and thanks for recommending it to me, because, like, it's movies like that I can really get behind. Also, speaking of samurais, I'll send you this one poster, which I also sent to Emily, which thankfully she responded to, right? Yeah, and she didn't simply, like, you know, like my the post I made. She actually commented her thoughts about it, which I do appreciate. I mean, it's fine to like something or say, oh, that's a cool whatever, but I'd like to hear your thoughts, even if it's brief. But it was nice to hear that, how this movie is called Sanjuro. It's a 1962 samurai flick, and yeah, I will, sis, trust me, but it's a 1962 samurai flick, which is a lot more dramatic than the first movie in a two-part series of Slav, Adam, and Cindy, yeah? Speaking of love, but yeah, I'm sure they loved each other, but it's about this samurai called Sanjuro. Tsuguru Sanjuro, I think, was his name, or whatever his name was. His backstory, man, is something that, you know, you just really feel for him, and underneath his very, like, dark sense of humor and just his demeanor and how he comes off as a sleazebag, he has been through some shit. And even the, I wish I knew her fucking name, if the cast even had given her a name. Yeah, the truth will come out, but, She wasn't, you know, her name was never known, but
I've never met another
it's the wife of this, you know, the head of this house, basically, is what she's called, his wife. How she saw right through his facade, and how underneath he's basically a unsheathed sword that's dented or wounded in his case, and that the best kind of swords, as she told him, is the ones that return back to its sheath. And you tell that his demeanor changed quickly, especially when she pretty much nailed what was going underneath the surface, and how he was clearly a very troubled and broken man, and yet he tried to hide it. And when you consider the fact that,
why did you pull me out of there while I was still unconscious?
Yeah, but when you consider the fact that he still had this badge for the house that he once belonged to, the House of Samurais, or his clan rather, it shows that
you just would have given them more time, they could have figured something out.
Whether he exiled from them, or he left them willingly, or he simply killed them, He never forgot where he came from, hence why he kept the badge on him rather than tear it off from his, I think you call it a shihakso, even though some would call it a kimono, even though kimonos are what, you know, what women would wear during that time and nowadays, unless you go to festivals, but yeah, when you go to festivals. But Joel should have been more honest with her. she would have definitely hated him, but not as much as when he lied to her continuously. But some can understand it. I can to an extent, but at least he took it like a man and didn't make any excuses. That's what I love about him once again, is the fact that he's a man's man who doesn't make any excuses for his actions, and he would do it all over again knowing that Ellie would hate him. But yeah, I love the fact also that Sanjuro, he let his guard down and basically revealed to her that everything she said was right, and how, like, you know, he was pretty much like saying without ever saying it to her, like, what the fuck do you know about me, woman, like that, you know. It's like, you know, he never thought anyone would get him, but she did. And if anything, she actually feels for him and was quite heartbroken when he decided to leave them and not stay with them. And basically, whether he was to be a bodyguard or simply be a part of their family, he just, you know, was a wandering samurai. He's what you call the wind, and how wherever the wind wanders or blows, he will flow with it, is what he was. And that's where Sanjuro's tale ends. It doesn't end like on a high note the way in Yojimbo. It ends in a more somber note, and especially with the ending where he killed the supposed antagonist, who is not so much really the bad guy. If anything, he was the one who was lied to, and fuck that bitch, but he was the one who was lied to and betrayed by Sanjuro, who basically acted as a double agent for him. So yeah, they somehow humanized the bad guy, the supposed bad guy of that film, and how he wanted justice, and by that he challenged Sanjuro to a duel. And my god, Sanjuro did not want to fight him because he knew how the outcome would be, and that guy said, even so, I still want to fight you, because he can't let his soul or conscious rest like Ellie can't his, unless he exacts some form of retribution, or at least attempt to, because he'd rather be dead than to not get some sort of revenge or payback for being betrayed, lied to, and just used like a puppet, even though Sanjuro was never proud of it, not once, especially to a fellow samurai doing that to him. But he did it for the lady of the house, and of course her daughter, or her I think her handmaiden, and her other children, and the people who work for her. She's a very kind lady, but it's obviously, I would say normally it's no excuse to lie, but he had no other choice. I mean, he was trying to avoid killing him. I mean, he could have gone down the route of killing him, but he chose to lie instead. But in turn, he also made him obsessed with revenge. But yeah, that's what happens when you basically make an enemy out of someone. But by the end, after he kills that guy, and that's the only time actually we see actual bloodshed, I mean, like, graphic blood. And unlike most movies, it's meant to show how truly, like, how truly wrong, disgusting, and just how painful this was, and how the violence, the graphic violence, emphasizes that. And I'm just gonna look for some items, but by the end, when the other, the other house servants and or samurais, student samurais, are praising Sanjuro, he basically told them to shut it and to not, like, you know, talk that way, because what the fuck do they know about, we're going that way. Is she Grillod, the kind of actually kind? Yeah, I had to. Yeah, that's pretty much that. But, he was not like he was not proud of killing him. That's why he told those guys to basically shut it, and that they have no idea what actual fights and what actual killing is like. It's not pretty. It's disgusting and horrible, and none of them should see it as something to be them praising him for, or others, because unlike in Yojimbo, which was the previous film in 1960, Sanjuro shows the more human and a lot more, painful side that comes with being a samurai, a lonesome samurai warrior like Sanjuro, who is what you call a rogue samurai, a ronin, someone who is without a master or lord. But yeah, he's referred to, by the way, as Sanjuro, because that's just the name I guess he was given, or the name he's referred to by the casting, or just, you know, in the credits, actually, sorry. But you could also call him the ronin. But yeah, I mean, he's really awesome, and just so human and relatable, unlike that fucking Quebecian cunt. But yeah, let's, you know, find out where we should go. But yeah, we have to, I guess, go this way, right here. Actually, no, we need to go back here and, let's see, this way to the gate here. No, we've gone through here. Sorry, I'm just a bit confused. Like, you know, they're quite similar. Will you be watching AEW tonight? Yeah, I will. I definitely will, especially with having seen last week's episode. And that reminds me, what time does AEW start? Because, you know, I hope that it doesn't, you know, start when the stream is going on, unless we reach the 1 hour and a half point, if not further. But yeah, I'm going to just go this way and land down, and we're gonna make further progress. But we progressed through quite a lot, cutting through here. Yeah, I fucking love Sam Porter Bridges and Norman Reedus. I cannot really emphasize enough to you, sis, how he really brought that character to life, and how he wasn't like, you know, Daryl Dixon from The Walking Dead. No. It's Norman Reedus becoming Sam Porter Bridges. But yeah, I love that character so much. And I also love when he's interacting with characters like Mama and Dead Man, and of course Die Hard Man, he is my second favorite character of the game. And oh yeah, he really is. I mean, he's one of those natural actors who, no matter how much you recognize his face, he really is a natural when it comes to playing characters and just being the characters. Progress, yeah, that's the key word. Our minds are in sync, but yeah, he plays characters no matter how well known he is, and humanizes them and just becomes them. And Sam Porter Bridges, like Guts, is also someone who does not even know why is he surviving. It's like, you know, why the fuck am I doing this shit? Making these, you know, basically delivering these boxes as a delivery man, and basically just doing his job on a day-to-day basis. That's his life, essentially, what it's become. And he's actually more satisfied doing that than with the saving the world crap. But yeah, I love that kind of character to Sam Porter Bridges, and I'm just trying to make distance for myself and those scumbags there. But yeah, when we pick them off, I just, you know, love Sam Porter Bridges because of that. He's so much like Guts, but also like Solid Snake, and you know, like fucking Sanjuro from Sanjuro, the film named after him. And let's see if we can take these douchebags out. Fuck you, bitch. Fuck you. Yeah. I do love Sam Porter Bridges, though, and just the similarities he draws from those characters. And definitely Guts. I mean, Guts, once again, he's not so much a character I can necessarily say I can be, because even though there are parts of him I've been through, or parts of him I can relate to, he's the kind of character like Solid Snake where you just can't be that kind of individual. Shoot this douchebag. Fuck you. Good shot. And we got him. And hello there. What's this? I guess for the, yeah, I mentioned this to you before on your stream, how basically that stupid-ass bitch named Hannah Marie Fulton, she was calling the hunters from The Last of Us 1, yeah, fuck Isaac, but she was calling the hunters from The Last of Us 1, like, you know, they weren't cannibals, they were just weird people doing weird shit. Oh, killing people, capturing them, and recording their weight, height, and whatever. And there's a fucking locker room full of their bodies, a meat locker room. It's fucking stupid, right? It's a hit list, and who knows? It could be a list of these fucking morons collecting, the list of meats they want to eat later. But yeah, the reason why I'm holding on to this is because, besides others who wish to read and pause it, is because my height is actually 5'7" or 5.75. But yeah, what's your height? If you don't mind me asking, because it's kind of funny. Karo is actually, I think, 5'6". Yeah, I think I'm certain it's she's 5'6". And she was like, it's not that taller than me. And I'm like, so? I mean, you asked me my height, so what the fuck do I give a shit if I'm that not much taller than you or not? 5'2". Yeah, and it's fine. It's perfectly fine. But yeah, it doesn't even really matter. But the thing is, oh, right, I think I know why. Because Kara mentioned how, back when she was bisexual or whatever, because now she labels herself as a lesbian, even though before she had a boyfriend, but whatever. Fuck sexual orientation. Just fuck people, but and this confusing nonsense and jargon, but she mentioned how, she loved very tall men who towered over her, which is quite a scary thought, because if I was a woman or even a dude, why do I want to have a boyfriend who could not only tower over me, but pick me up and throw me over like a fucking wall, like one of these bloaters or the shamblers or whatever they are, or fucking Biggie Smalls, the notorious B.I.G. who his girlfriends in the past, back when he was alive, I would be scared shitless if he were to pick me up the way I believe he did, because I think it's well documented that he beat up his girlfriends, right? Oh, right, what the perks, yeah. I'm sure it does, but it doesn't scare you in the slightest that he could possibly hurt you or break you in half, knowing how fucking huge he is, especially if he was a bodybuilder. I mean, what the fuck? It's like having fucking Kratos as a boyfriend. And better yet, not only would you kick his ass and give him a knee strike, kickboxing knee strike to his face or his jaw, but you would kick his balls as a final move. Feel her love, fuck you, is what I say to that cringy crap. But yeah, she was never really my type to begin with, even long before when we became siblings, essentially. And yeah, I'm just being the truth, being honest, just like how she was pretty blunt with how she said, oh, it's not that taller than me, in regards to how she likes taller men who aren't just tall, but tower over her. And I'm like, okay, good luck finding a girlfriend now, since she apparently identifies as lesbian or whatever. But man, this love shit is just hurting my head, All the needless mental stress with this kind of love and shit. And hello there, kitty. I think Angel just got in the game. I know some tall girls or women. Sorry, I just have to show the respect and love the women. But yeah, girls, I've no doubt that they were tall and that they would crush any dudes who are either just as tall as they are, shorter, or hell, even taller, depending on how tall you can get. But yeah, tall women, man. It's like the fucking episode of Johnny Bravo on the Cartoon Network show Johnny Bravo, where he basically described the Bride of Frankenstein as having the strength of 10 women. And I was like, that's me. That's fucking me, right? Oh my god, what a fucking coincidence, or rather, talkers speak of the devil. But yeah, the devilish cats. But I mean, Johnny Bravo is so me when he described, wow, she has the strength of 10 women. That's pretty much me, man, when it comes to, strong women. The fact that I would chase after them to the point because of how fucking badass they are. I mean, that's the kind of woman I love so much. I'm not sure how Karo is, really, because, let's just say that she uses words like cuddling without any trouble, even though that word is cringe to me. Like the word, I rarely use the word lover, but that word itself and many other words like that is cringe to me as all hell. That's why I give the fist pumps rather than the heart emoji, unless it comes to someone I really do care about and show myself the side only a few times. But yeah, I'm not sure how she is when it comes to whether a fight or just so when it comes to personally, I would really like to meet her and find out, but I'm sure she's tough. But man, women like Jack and of course Sarah. My God, I'm having, you know, I know how this is done thanks to you. Thanks, sis. Oh yeah, you are the best tutorial, A plus, baby. But yeah, I just love Sarah so much. I'm just, you know, going googly eyes over her because of how fucking badass she is. But yeah, not sure about Caro, but I just love women like that. And yeah, you can be as tall as if you want, but if you don't got the balls to basically, let's see, yeah, we need to pull it a bit closer, but if you don't got the balls to basically fight for what you believe in or stand up for yourself, what good would the fucking height do, you know? But yeah, let's pull this crap. Uh-huh. A plus. Thank you, sis. Oh yeah, we did it. Mm-hmm. It worked like a fucking damn fiddle. Or we played it like a fucking damn fiddle. But yeah, even if Carl was watching, which I doubt, all I can say is, I'm sorry, but that's some facts for you. Just like she shared some facts with me, which was quite shocking about her being lesbian and shit, even though she had claimed at one point she was bi, then she was confused, and then she was, you know, binary lesbian, and then all this labels and shit. It reminds me of fucking Michael Keaton in this movie, which I hate so much, but it's that one line which came from this movie called The Birdman, where he basically talked about labels, and now, like, critics love to use the labels a lot when it comes to criticizing a movie which they never even bothered watching, or when it comes to a stage play which they never even bothered to watch, and they just criticize and use big words to basically sound all smart, but all they come off as a fucking con artist. But yeah, I mean, you can tell me that I'm not your type, but don't be a fucking douchebag about it. I mean, she pretty much said that when talking about the height and crap, but I'm like, you asked my height, so cool, and we're way ahead. Oh yeah, it's just a form of exploring who you are. Oh, that would make sense, but it's just the way she's like not that taller than me, and she used that emoji with like the wink and the tongue sticking out and that shit. But yeah, it's pretty much what else am I supposed to think about that? I mean, if it's a sense of humor, it's not my kind of humor, unless we're talking about, like, you know, not us personally. I mean like, If let's say that the best example I can give is when she was talking about how her memory was not as good. I told her that it's fine, it's all right, it happens to the best of us, or in my case, the worst of us. But yeah, that's the kind of humor you can do without, like, you know, insulting anyone. But if you want to basically make fun of yourself every now and then, it's fine, without, like, you know, it sounding like you're putting yourself down. It's about balance. That's why comedy is a science, and it's an art, essentially. And how, I'm sorry to say, but Carol does not seem to have the balance to that. A lot of times she can be really funny, but when it comes to me, it's like, yeah, I get it, I'm not your type, but just chill out with that, you know? Like that kind of thing, about balance. But whatever. And let's find some more stuff here. I do love her, though, but it's just things like that that can't help but be honest with you about. And I did get a message from her, though, when she said that she liked the owl... the picture of three owls, which I sent her as a gift because of how much she loved the owls. I told her, no prob, but let's go inside one of these doors and see what we can find. hopefully some more bodies to pile up. And hello there. Wow, there was something similar to this, I believe, in... trying to think of... Well, what was the... Oh, right, Saints Row 3. Saints Row 3, the artwork of Zemos. Good, good old Zemos. I mean, it's pretty gorgeous, the art style and the Nomad, you don't say. I've actually been in one of these... one of my psychiatrists actually had a clinic like this, exactly the way this is designed. And I was waiting in the couch here, you know, waiting for them to call my to call me up when it was my turn to basically talk with my psychiatrist after he or she was done with his or her patient. And yeah, it's kind of weird how when I was talking with my psychiatrist, a lot of them had no clue how they're able to help me, since I'm fully aware of most of the things that was wrong with me. But yeah, really nice. And oh yeah, and thanks for the free ammo, honey. Fucking wolf. Yeah, fucking wolves. They call her a wolf too, even though she's not part of their pack. But yeah, everyone's a wolf, even though they don't represent what it means to be a wolf. And hello. Yeah, the fucking apes, whatever you call them, the prime ape-like infected. I don't know what the fuck you call them, but I'm gonna have me some fun, sis. I'm gonna have me some fun going back to our primal instincts when men were animals, and we have to be animals ourselves. And yeah, let's, you know, pick them off. And stalkers, right? Thank you for the info, but let's pick them off one by one. And once we do that and get out of this shithole, we're gonna end it. Yeah, those fuckheads, they're disgusting as all hell, but man, oh man, will I have fun with them. Oh yeah, let's play, bitches. Let's fucking play. Hey, cocksucker, take this. Bitch! Let's see. Reload. Yeah? Odd. Yeah, it's funny. I was actually in the same position you were back when you picked off these motherfuckers, but yeah, they're coming this way, I believe. Not sure. Because of the sense can sometimes be a bit weird or obscure when it comes to the stalkers here. But yeah, they live up to their names, and can't wait. Obviously, they can see us, unlike the clickers, and of course the, I guess you call them the shamblers, but yeah. They're here somewhere. I don't want to, you know, bother crafting some alcohol. Where is your alcohol? I'm sorry, I had to do that. But, unless we pick them off, but let's do that and, let's see. Good aim. Gotcha, bitch. Gotcha. And fuck you! Gotcha! Bullseye. Hello? Yeah, come on. And fuck you! Bullseye! He didn't got hit once. Two bullseyes. And one burning, and yep, and fuck you! Fuck you! Yeah, none of you cocksuckers even touched us, assholes. Not once, right? Got him, oh yeah. Clean. That is what you call being a boss. Fuck you, Sasha Banks, wherever the fuck she is. But yeah, that's what you call being a boss, is what we are. And let's craft some Molotov. But yeah, conserve your ammos, and of course, eyes on the targets. In the same vein as, William, whatever, from A Knight's Tale. I forgot Heath Ledger's character, the late great Heath Ledger's character's name in that movie, but... William Thatcher was his name. I thought Shatner for some reason, but it's William Thatcher. But yeah, it's like, you know, he keeps his eyes on the target as as you know, Jocelyn described, a true warrior. And Jocelyn, by the way, is dear William's love interest. And both he and Jocelyn, I don't really like all that much. Especially when he called Jocelyn a silly girl. I'm like, she's a woman, but I'm glad she responded back, like, you know, better a silly girl with a flower than a silly boy with a horse and a stick. I love that shit so much. He was commenting to her about, like, you know, how she liked to change dresses and how she liked flowers and how she described how flowers are meant to represent something more than just the appearance, and how he called her a silly girl for having that kind of philosophy. And I was like, sure, what the fuck are you, Mr. Knight? And she basically said the exact same thing I did, only with his stupid horse and stick. But yeah, no offense to the horse, it's just like, you know, it's quite stupid of him to say something like that, knowing that you pretty much blew your chance with her by insulting her, even though, yes, I guess I know he was in a bad mood, but still, taking it out on her, I mean, you pretty much blew your chance with her by losing your shit like that, you know? I mean, it's like, you know, when that idiot punk lost his shit over something Miz tweeted out or just said in after I think, you know, whatever that show was that you know, Renee Young host and also Paige host. And yeah, it's that one job exactly, to basically, just like with Punk and William, it's to keep his mouth shut and to not talk so much, or like, if you need to cool off, just tell her, I'm sorry Jocelyn, I'm not really in the right state of mind, and tell her this with absolute, you know, respect and manner. That's exactly what I would do. That's why every time, like example, before I go off your stream, I go like, oh, I'm sorry Candace or sis, I have something that came up, I'm gonna catch up on your stream later or some shit like that, but I'm sorry once again, but it's been fun, that kind of shit. No one needs to say it in that kind of detail, but still, it's at least good to know that someone really does care. But yeah, others won't know that, you know, you care even without saying it, but some words would help, you know. But yeah, and let's take out these douchebags. But that's the thing. He should have had some manners. Same with the punk. And not just lose his shit like that. And plus, here's the thing: if he wanted to take his shit out on anyone for the blood money and shit, which the idiots at the WWE love to take from that shit country, he had to take it out on Miz and basically do that stunt with him. Why? What does Miz have to do with it? Fucking douchebag he was. But yeah, fuck Punk. And especially when you know that Miz actually defended Punk once when he left the company to become a MMA fighter. And fuck you, goddammit. I did not know they would run away like that. But yeah, they're waiting for us, hence why they're called stalkers. But let's see them. Yeah. And fuck you, bitch. Yeah, need to switch it up. I love how these bitches love to hide and find cover or whatever, and the fuck, yeah, we got you. Aim for the fucking head. What the fuck? These bitches love to stalk us, don't they? Yeah, fuck you. Okay, fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. Yeah, fuck you and run. Fuck. Yeah, fuck. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with all this running around crap. Fuck. Yeah, they're fast. I'd actually like them because of that. I'm going to read your post in a minute, sis. Just need to take out these cocksuckers and... Fuck. Yeah. Let's fight. We're taking them out the old-fashioned way, and if they're going to run like that, then fine. Fuck you. Shit, that's the end of us, and no, not today, not fucking today, and hop, Ellie, hop! God damn it! Hello, let's dance, bitch. Come here and let's dance. you. Wow. The hunter, the hunted has become the hunter, and vice versa. Where's that bitch? I love the shit though. It goes back to what I was saying. We become the animal. We go back to man's primal instinct, and the woman, not the girl, becomes the hunter and the animal, hunting down her prey. I love that shit. I do. It's exactly how I would really behave, especially when, you know, it's like, you know, Ethan from RE7. I love, this is the best example besides this moment. It's like, you know, when he, at first he was scared, but then he became pissed as all fucking hell, especially when Jack Baker pushed him to his breaking point and he finally had it with, you know, running away. And he's like, he basically told him, come on, old man, let's do this. I love the fact he called him old man, and basically he even insulted him, saying how, like, you know, how the old man is so slow and how he can't, you know, basically hit him. I love a character like Ethan, who's the protagonist, and yet he talks shit to the bad guy, and some would actually feel bad for the bad guy because of how he's saying, like, you know, he's too slow and how he's getting too slow for his age and shit or whatever. But yeah, I love that kind of shit when they talk back to the antagonist and fuck being the goody two shoe. It's that kind of thing I love so much, and also why I love Guts. But yeah, this is why I also love Ellie. But yeah, we became the hunter. I love that kind of shit. I mean, this is why, with the exception of you, who I love seeing destroy these guys, I will never watch others do Let's Play series or live stream unless they actually go. In moments like these, they stop being a pussy-ass bitch and go full animalistic with these guys, because it fits the theme, you know. You become the hunter and you go after those who've wronged you or those who think that they got you caught off guard. No, you know, basically deceive them. That's you becoming the predator and on top of the food chain, as Batista used to say in those vignettes of his when, you know, he was the animal being unleashed back in 2005 and 2006 too. But yeah, can these Let's Players or live streamers stop being a fucking pussy for once and just actually flow with the theme of the game like that, you know? How you just go, enough is enough already. I mean, what the fuck was Ethan? He was, you know, sick and tired of running and seeing what was happening to his wife, and the fact that if he doesn't act now, his wife would be dead, and if she does not act, her husband would be dead. So yeah, I love how it switches between both of them, by the way, the point of view. And I would say personally, right? I would say personally, it works better in that game than here. And that game was released in 2017 and revitalized the horror genre, basically. But yeah, I love a truly strong character who just so happened to be a woman, like, what's her name? Mia Winters. But yeah, Mia and Ethan, you cannot, you know, include... talk about RE, but without mentioning both their names, like Mia and Ethan, and yeah, the hospital, that's where we should be. It's like, you know, one of those French horror films which I've seen, where basically the couple are stuck with each other in this prison, which they're trapped in by these cannibals, and they're assuring each other that they'll be alright, and that they both of them struggle to survive, and how one saves the other, and they repay back the favor. But yeah, thank you all for watching, and thank you for the two highlights, sis, and also for just the tweet and everything. But until tomorrow, peace out and rock on.